Now let's have a look at the poetic devices that have been used in this poem. The first is anaphora. Anaphora is the repetition of the same word in different lines. The first three lines, where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments. We see that each of the three lines start with where. So this is where anaphora as a poetic device has been used. Next is lines 5, 6 and 7. Where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way. Again, where has been used in the three lines in the very beginning. Next is lines 10 and 11. Into ever-widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. Here the two lines start with the same word into. So anaphora has been used in these three places. Next we have alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of the sound of the first words in two consecutive words. Like high held, both start with H. Been broken, both start with B. Where words, both start with W. Dreary desert, both start with D, and striving stretches, both start with S. So at these five places, alliteration has been used. Next, we have a metaphor. Metaphor, clear stream of reason. The clear stream is being actually compared to logical thinking. So when there is such a comparison, we say we are using metaphor. Similarly, in dead habit is actually being used in place of old religious superstitions and beliefs. Next is personification. Personification is as if we are, similar to metaphor, just in this case we do not use objects as for comparison, rather we use movements. So a tireless striving stretching its arms towards perfection. So here we are stretching its arms, so some movement is happening. So hence we are personifying the comparison.